Tell me a little bit about that process of making the record. Because like Stevie Wonder, you play all the instruments. You do everything.
Yeah, I guess I'm somewhat of a control freak, but I think it was more out of circumstance and trying to recreate that sort of demo process of being, you know, when you're in your bedroom with a four track and you kind of get lost in the moment and hours go by and you forget to eat food and all of a sudden you come up with these really deeply atmospheric demos, you know, and I think there's something about those demos that you always try and recapture in a studio that it never has that same sort of magic. So I guess I tried to use that demo sort of aesthetic but do it with some good, you know, analog gear in a studio.
Tell me about the studio, because I heard the studio is a good studio, but also the desk has a history as well.
Yeah, I got to use an old Neve console that was actually built for Pete Townsend and The Who, and it's actually, when you turn the thing on, the lights come up 666.
Wow.
Which is pretty funny. First time it happened, it kind of freaked me out, but then I got told, no, that was on purpose for Pete or something like that. But yeah, no, it definitely has a lot of history, that desk, and I got to use some just beautiful old analog stuff. I didn't use any computers or anything, and all this gear was being stored up in an attic while my father's studio was being built in the downstairs area, so I was kind of all in one room with all this cluttered mess, and yeah, it was really good fun.
Remember me, honestly, I don't remember who you are. Has never been the best. You want a second chance. You stand around your haunted home.